Hi, I'm Maheen from AWS.
Hi, I'm Hamza from Salesflo, and this is my architecture.
So today we are talking about a serverless architecture that helps with building and customizing workflows for large organizations. So Hamza, talk to me about the customer challenge that led to the solution.
Sure. For businesses spread over large geographical landscapes, effective compliance control, monitoring, and visibility is crucial for growth. For example, consumer good companies hire hundreds or thousands of field forces to improve product visibility in stores, and any delays, for example, in replacement of stocks can lead to losses. This is where Salesflo Engage comes in. It helps to effectively manage on-ground operations by providing live visibility into any tasks that are performed and actually gives insight that help empower informed decisions.
Let's dive in.
Sure. So there are two parts of the application. First is the web application that is used to configure workflows and journey plans. So let's dive straight into that. So the domain is hosted on to Amazon Route 53. And then we have API gateway that serves as the communication between the front end and the back end of the application. API gateway then invokes the back end processing through AWS Fargate and Lambda. So we use AWS Fargate for more complex and long running jobs such as data validations and image processing.
And what about jobs that don't take long?
So we use AWS Lambda for short-running jobs, such as transactional data processing, could be add, update, delete of operations of the web application itself. And it is actually connected through Amazon RDS to store that transactional data. We also have Elastic Cache for frequently accessed data so that we don't go on to throttle the database.
So what sort of volumes are we talking when you use Elastic Cache?
Absolutely. So we have observed that at peak load times, it can be a million concurrent users. Hence, it makes a lot of sense to use it for frequently accessed data such as session management and user permissions so that we don't end up throttling the transactions onto the database.
Now, coming to the mobile application there, help me understand, how does a user get access to the data?
Absolutely. So the mobile application is sending large streams of data, such as the workflow analytics data and the user tracking data. So we reliably ingest that data using Kinesis Firehose. And Firehose actually natively backs up that data onto an S3 bucket. We also have AWS Lambda. So what happens is the Kinesis actually then aggregates that data and sends the payload onto a Lambda function. The Lambda function parses that data and passes onto a state machine that is configured using AWS Step functions. So whatever workflow that was designed on the web application is actually modularly configured at the backend through AWS Step functions. So these configurations could be something as like alarms for the users, for key business metrics. So whenever the thresholds for those metrics are breached, the Step function notifies the simple notification service to prompt the user to take some actions. So these prompts could be through email or SMS or from the mobile application as well.
Okay, yeah. Fantastic. And you've got dashboard and reporting for the web application there, and there is Athena and Glue. So help me understand the purpose for Athena and Glue here.
Absolutely. So the data is also then sent to Lambda, which is stored onto a relational database for safekeeping. And then actually what Kinesis does very interesting is to send that data in a consolidated manner into Amazon S3. So let me just go and draw a line here.
Yeah.
And what it does interesting is to actually convert the data into Apache Parquet format, which is a big data ready format, and it actually compresses the data by 90%. This helps us to actually make analysis of later on. So Amazon S3 then acts as a foundation for data lake. And we use Amazon Glue to actually, Glue Scrawler actually, to identify, classify that data, and then to catalog it. Then we use Amazon Athena to actually query that data on demand. What happens is when the application user wants dashboards or reporting, it can go and query Amazon Athena. And it can get the data on demand from S3. without the need of actually provisioning long-running EMR clusters or warehouses.
Fantastic. So Hamza, obviously using dashboards and reporting, one of the main activities is efficiency gains. So what stats can you quote in terms of what the customers have been able to achieve?
I think with enhanced visibility of data and reporting, customers are actually able to improve their field force performance by 30%, primarily focusing on two key metrics, that is the in-field time spent and better market coverage.
Fantastic. Hamza, thank you for walking us through the fantastic architecture you've built here for workflow management. And thank you for watching This Is My Architecture.
Thank you.